in desperate attempt news. Submitted by Frozen Pizza.
Oh, I used to be envious of all the white kids who got frozen pizza.
I never had DiGiorno.
What? It's actually pretty fucking good.
It's really good.
It's pretty fucking good.
You should order one. I'm gonna order one. I'll buy one.
I always saw it at the market.
It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno, yeah. Bart.
It's in their motto.
Is that an order?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He just went against their whole slogan.
What Postmates at DiGiorno then?
It comes in the bag, right? Because I've seen it at the market. I never did it.
All you gotta do is toss it in.
It's a box.
Yeah, and it has like a tray on the bottom. You just throw it in.
Yeah. Easy peasy. And it comes out really
good. It's pretty fucking good. I'm not
gonna
lie.
Crunchy on the bottom. Shit. Soft crust.
Damn. You should get one.
It doesn't taste like pizza pizza. It's like its own version.
Yeah, it's good though.
It's good.
All right. Submitted by, a woman apparently faked her own death for a free dress.
What?
How dope is this dress and how amazing does it make her look?
Is it a wedding dress?
It's not a wedding dress.
What the fuck? I've done some shady shit for a dress before.
Dude, that's fucked.
I'll tell you after.
No, tell us first.
No, you already. You can't say that.
You can't say that. You can't even do it.
All right. So this was when I was broke and I had to go to a wedding.
Why don't you tell the story after the mid roll?
So I had to go to a wedding and I was broke and this family that I was going to the wedding for was pretty ballin'. So I couldn't just get like a regular looking dress because it looked regular as fuck.
Yeah.
So I needed to go to the very bare minimum Nordstrom, and then when I saw like the price, it was like $400.
Yeah.
And it was just one night event. I'm like, fuck man, what am I gonna do? Fuck it. I'm gonna put it on credit. Leave the tags on. This is disgusting. So then I went to the wedding. I looked fly. I fit in very well. I faked the funk.
How old were you?
Maybe like my early 20s.
Okay.
Yeah, I was legal to drink. So maybe like 21, 22.
I'm already like so, wow. I can't believe you did something like this, Gio. Like I thought I knew
you. Are you judging me?
And yeah, I'm like losing respect. This is
I've changed. I've gone to church since then. Really? I've repented.
And I have money.
I already know where this is going. But go on.
I went out dancing, sweating. Mm. I even went to fucking Norebang. Oh. And you know, this is the time when like the Norebang's out here, they would allow you to smoke indoors, and it's like this like there's no windows, it's a door, so you're like it's just stuffy.
You didn't even change out of the fucking dress?
I can't. How would I get changed into? I was broke. I didn't have anything that would like.
Oh, you went to a Norebang. That means you're supposed to change out of it. And
nobody changed. Nobody changed.
Oh shit.
What's a Norebang?
Karaoke.
Okay, private room.
Yeah. And then the following day, tags were still on. It was dope. I put it back in the bag and I'm like, I need to return this because it smells like cigarettes. And then they're like, ugh. And they gave me a full refund. And that fucked up.
They're like, where did the cigarette smell come from? You.
I was like, did somebody wear this before and go to a Norebang after a wedding? Because that's what this smells like.
I know, so I'm not gonna judge this lady because I did.
I lost total respect. You should have stole the dress, Gio. Like,
oh my God.
You should have been more honorable.
What? That's okay. Where
I'm committed.
You know why? Okay, let me tell you why, okay? It's like if I bought toilet paper, wiped my ass, and gave it back to them to put it back on a shelf.
Dirty toilet paper or the remainder?
No, if I got the toilet paper and I wiped my ass and instead of fucking wipe, like throw, I rolled it back up and put it on the
How
shelf.
How do you compare?
That's the same shit.
How do you compare
it's
feces to just water coming out of your pores?
No, but it's your sweat, it's the stank, it's all that stuff. I would have just stole it.
Every girl's sweat smells like fucking roses.
I'll tell you this right now. If we put it in today's context, somebody would buy that dress off eBay for about $4,000 and they would masturbate it to it right now.
That's true. That's just because they're not famous. You are famous, but if you are famous, people will
but
buy
But I'm not
dresses.
Even famous now. Have people would be like, this smells like shit. You know what? I'm very proud to say that in 2018, somebody finally asked to buy my underwear.
Really?
Yes.
Really? For how much?
Huh?
Was it after that video?
I don't know.
I got a whole bunch of DMs of people like, I'm serious. Serious question today.
How much?
Dirty socks. How much? I'm like,
no, I've gotten the picture of my toes.
I'll let you guys negotiate for me because I haven't even responded.
Yo, give it to me!
Yeah, give me a percentage. Give me a percentage.
For sure, I'll give you a percentage.
Well, Tiffany, I'm not as popular as you, okay? I only got one.
I'll put
not
it to
because
you like
in
this?
The video, you were saying you weren't down. In the video, I was saying I was down. That's why I got
it. Oh, so
I'll
she's
put it
still
to you
down.
Like this, though. This is how it starts. The regular underwear, the ones that aren't too cute, we start at $4,000. If you want to go a little bit to the bikini style ones over here, we're talking about $10,000. You want to go G-string? We got to talk about that later. You know what I'm saying?
That's expensive.
Yeah.
But you need to up it a little bit.
You want these ones.
I know, it's used, yeah, it's, yeah, worth it.
Oh, if it's used, we're having a different conversation.
Well, you gotta pay the picture.
Yeah, they want you.
Oh, like, we gotta go higher.
You gotta be like, this week, Gio had the stomach flu, and she had diarrhea all week.
The
and
discharge,
this pair,
yeah,
of underwear has skid marks all over. Get this for, yeah, $20,000.
Oh, this week,
Tiffany decided to do a little bit of yoga this week.
Yeah, oh yeah.
This pair of underwear she wore all week, and...
All week?
Oh, you didn't watch all it week. Once.
Yep.
Okay.
That's pungent.
You guys should sell tampons and stuff too.
Yeah!
Amazing that is that they just want anything with your fucking fecal matter on it, and then they just immediately want to pay money for it.
But they want vag matter too.
Yeah.
So
and vag matter.
Vag matter?
Vag matter. It sounds like a new Frank Ocean song.
I know.
Vag matter.
In the world of men, right, if we were fish, they're like the allergy eater that fucking cleans up.
Oh, yeah!
So they're like the bottom feeder of men that just, I just want the sweat of a woman.
Yeah.
And we're just like, ooh, girl, go take a shower and shit. And they're like, no, let me lick it off.
Oh my God.
That's no, awesome. Some of the offers were insulting though. They're like, 30 bucks for
get the fuck at 30 bucks? You better get the fuck out of here. You talking to me, bitch. Four grand minimum for the granny panties. And that's slightly used. If you want that fucking dang shit.
Yup.
The fucking hiking panties.
I'm for real though, that's $4,000 though.
Four mile hiking panties.
But at least five. Anyways,
the $4,000 top one is they sharded on it.
Okay.
Ooh.
Well, let's talk about
you're the sharder, not us, dude.
You can sell your boxers.
I know, but the secret is all shard. And I'll say that it's yours.
Okay.
All shard in the girl's underwear.
There you go.
Yeah, so anyways, this lady here, she goes by the name of Jennifer. And so it all started, first of all, let me show you guys LuLaRoe. So this is the clothing brand that she's... You remember we talked about this company before, that they're kind of like a pyramid scheme?
Oh, yeah.
So it's like this company, it's kind of like Avon, where you can only get it from the people that sell it.
Oh, yeah.
I would have never buy those clothes.
I know, these clothes are ugly.
I know somebody who dresses like this, and I hate looking at her. Because she shows out as if she looks really good, and I'm like, you are embarrassing me, and I look like this. So get your ass back in the house and wear something decent.
Is it your girlfriend?
No.
Oh, okay.
Hell no. Mary don't listen to dress like that.
I know, that's because you were like saying go back into the house, like if you had authority over her. So I'm like, wait,
Mary doesn't dress like that. No. It's in my mind.
Yeah, David, you don't have authority over women like that.
Shut the fuck up, John.
We're not, it's not like, it's 2018, okay?
Yeah, it's not like it's 2017.
Yo, bootleg Michael Jackson over there is pissing me off.
He's a social justice warrior today. Okay,
so. Fucking woke as hell, dude.
Hey, I'm a new man. It's January 2018, and I'm learning a lot.
That's it. You turned off.
Yeah, I know. It's like
he's learning a lot.
Yeah, so this all started with this conversation here. So Jennifer is the gray bubble, and she hit up one of the people selling the LuLaRoe. So it's called the Amelia dress. That's the dress that she's looking for. So
okay, what the fuck it called?
Yeah. So then she hits up the seller, and so apparently they had a conversation, like her trying to inquire about the dress. And then that same day, a few hours later, there was this message from her page that says, "I'm going through my wife's phone. She was on the way to Redacted this morning, and was hit head on by a person texting and did not make it. This is her husband. How do I pay this bill? I know how much she wanted this, and I'm going to have her buried in it."
That's funny.
So that's the message that was sent. So then the seller...
I would have been like, why would she wear that garbage shit to fucking the death time?
Not only that, but it's like your wife just died and you're worried about what dress you're gonna bury her in? Like, come on.
Yeah, you wouldn't even be answering a text like this.
Exactly. Yeah. So then the seller ends up taking this screenshot here, and she posts it in like a LuLaRoe like page, like Facebook page. And so she's just saying like, have any of you guys ever dealt with this girl? Like, I don't know, I just got this weird message, like it just seems off. And then that entire thread, like they just start going in like, this sounds fake, like did she really just like fake her own death or whatever? So then one of the girls from that Facebook group sends her, the Jennifer, sends her a message saying, "Hey girl, you're the winner of a free Lula item in my group. Congrats. And then like the boutique will be open tomorrow for you to shop.
Boutique, spelled boutique, B-O-O-T-E-K.
It's a real website.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was, I thought that she thought had boutique. Oh God.
I thought so too, and I had to Google it.
Because somebody spelled suicide on my shit as suicide. And that shit made me crack the fuck up. Said, suicide?
Yeah, so then Jennifer responds, oh my god, I never win anything. What style can I choose from? I live in redacted, so you can send it to me. So can you send it to me? So then that person, the second seller, ends up posting that on the group and saying like, see, this bitch is lying. Yeah. Like, she's fucking alive.
Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. This is so fucking funny to me because these fucking spineless ass people are in a fucking pyramid scheme and now they're all like fucking high and mighty. Like, this bitch is trying to like fucking pull the fast one on us. Like, fuck you guys. I didn't forget.
That's true. It's a pyramid scheme.
Well, they probably don't even know that they're in a pyramid. Yeah, a lot of people don't realize it.
Fine.
Yeah, who the fuck do you think you are? Anyone that's a part of Herbalife, Amway, or any of those things, they have no clue that they're a part of a cult. No clue.
Fine.
Sure.
No clue. They have no idea.
But I like, take it back.
How poor is this person's taste that they want to steal this dress?
Some people are crazy.
But see, that's what I'm worried about this person, because you could steal better things. Way better things. Like, you could literally rip this carpet off and make it better.
Maybe she didn't want to pay the bill. Maybe she didn't want to pay the bill, like she just took it and then she was just like...
Yeah, it was like a $60 dress, apparently.
No, that is not worth $60.
Fake her death for a $60 dress?
I've seen better shit at Macy's on a sale rack.
I've stolen a lot less for cheapers.
Yeah, so then the second seller ends up responding to that saying, yes, no items excluded. But I just saw a post where someone messaged from this profile about his wife dying. Is that true? She was like, do what? From my profile? It is absolutely not true. What group is this in? This is crazy.
From my profile.
Yeah. And then
this is crazy.
She's the worst criminal ever.
And then the second seller sends the screenshot from the first seller to this Jennifer and she says, what the? This is crazy. My husband is at work and hasn't even been around my phone.
Oh gosh, she made it even worse.
Yeah. And then the second seller is like, well, I tagged you in the post, but then you left the group. I tried to let you clear it up. So we can understand. So like this girl just made it even worse by leaving the group, and she also blocked, Jennifer ends up blocking the first seller, so then she can't even communicate with her anymore, so it's just like more obvious that you're lying.
And now you're on the news, bitch.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then it continues, and then like...
You sound like Taika.
No, and then she goes off and saying like, I'm going to the police about this. Like, someone hacked my stuff. It's not fair. They're dragging my name through here and blah, blah, blah.
Oh, no.
And then apparently...
They tarnished your reputation. Now you'll never be able to sell those fucking clothes.
Or buy those clothes, yeah.
You're tarnished. Oh, no, the whole world knows now. Oh, my God, what are we going to do? We must clear her name. Guys, she got hacked.
Yeah, so then she says that she goes to the police because her brother-in-law is a police officer, and that all of a sudden, within that hour, they found out who hacked into her account, and she got like an arrest warrant, and that they went to go arrest this
person. They'll take care of it.
The SWAT team broke in. They smoked the house down, they hogtied the whole family, and it got the fucking hackers.
Yeah, and then so the people from that, like all the sellers, in that other Facebook group, because like they're sending screenshots to that group so that everyone's in on it, in on this story. And so then they start saying like, wow, congratulations, that city's police department. You guys are amazing. They even gave them, they even reviewed that police station and said A+ on the Jennifer blank Facebook case.
And then the police station's
within
like...
Within the hour.
Thanks.
Yeah, they're like, what?
What's going on?
Yeah, so they even like raided the police department and...
I love the internet.
Oh, this is the dress, by the way. And it's like,
oh my god, what the fuck?
This is the dress.
Oh.
And there was this other seller in that group. There was a different seller in the group that said that she had previously sold her leggings.
I am so fucking mad.
That shit just looks like every shade of a bruise that ever existed.
100% it's because she went to a Thanksgiving party and that was the theme.
That's exactly what it is.
It's part of the Halloween catalog or whatever. So
of
I
course.
Guess that's the
color. it's the costume of a scary dress.
Yes. It is definitely a great Halloween costume because you look like you murdered fashion. So I hate you.